SBF family, it's Wendy, and guess what? Finally, I am getting on to another video journal series for another room in the 40 plus room Monster High dollhouse that is quickly going to become 50 plus rooms. And so we will begin another room, which will actually be two rooms. This, of course, is part one. Part one always is concept ideas, let you know where I'm at, and getting started. These wood pieces were cut. They are leftovers. You've seen that in the last one, the pow pop. And I'm going to repeat that in case somebody didn't see that after this particular segment to show how it was just scrapped together. So if anybody's wondering, unfortunately, the process in which I figured out this bottom size, I did on the next project. So I will show how I made a pattern for that. So here we go. We got the live cabin. And we had a package opening for that from eBay. I got a great deal. I forget the price, but it was really decent. And it came with everything. I believe it was only missing like a spoon or a knife or something. So it has all of its pieces. Speaking of which, let's do a shout out to Falcon Productions. I'm enjoying your comments and enjoying your stop motions. I respect them hugely with what little I've tried to do. I'm just amazed. So it's got lots of pieces in here and the stuff that's going to make it look like a real cabin. And that is super exciting that it came with everything. I didn't want to do much to this, but I'm going to have to because I'm getting a little greedy for space. And instead of a bottom floor, I'd like to make it two floors. It's called a cabin on stilts. Alex thought I was crazy, but I actually Googled it and there's tons of them. So if you can imagine, he cut these pieces, which were some scraps we had around. Somebody left in our garage years ago. And I'm going to use, obviously, let me pull that back, one on each corner and lift this piece right up. And then this bottom piece will be the base. Not sure how I'm going to land. I like some landscaping. Not sure how I'm going to do it. So the characters for this, I obviously want a spot for Who Dude. That's special since he's a San Diego Comic-Con. It's special, you know, he's just cool. He needs his own spot. And then I wanted this bedroom type area for Finnegan. And so that's where I'm all at with this. Let's see, we had this, came with the little mini dollhouse that I still have yet to do, and I'm looking forward to that. So I can use these pieces, be it up here or underneath. I don't know, I'm still kind of just not sure where I'm going with this. It's kind of going to go as it grows. Let's see. I found these were left over, or I'm going to pull the ones out of the beach and put them in here because it's kind of a little bit cooler to have the fish from the beach. These I found at Staples. They were only a buck. And I'm not sure. I might have them as storage down underneath or put them in the garage. I have them here now for ideas. Let's see. Some stuff from the Garage Boys stuff where I did the World War collection kind of stuff. This came with it, which is just a sleeping bag, green. So I may or may not use that. Plus we got what this came with, which was the hammock. I like the concept. I hate the pink, obviously. I don't mind this so bad. Maybe if we change that, or maybe I'll connect this over to the stilts. I don't know. I have a handkerchief or bandana that I used to wear, and I don't know more, so I might use that, but might not because the garage has a lot of camouflage things. So then I might go for this, which is a leftover pillow I made some years ago and then took the form out and kept the fabric. So maybe animal print. That's something we don't really have in this doll room, so that might be the way I go for pillows and extras. Who knows, but I will definitely check it out. Now, I don't like the pink, of course. Just doesn't go at all. And I don't like all these stickers for the most part. Now, you see how it's got that little ledge that shows you where to put the stickers? I hate those. And they're everywhere on here. Of course, I'm going to use caulking. If you watch that faux texture, how I was talking about that versatility of that, the caulking, I'm going to, that's nice and easy, peel these off, fill that in, probably do some circles like it's stucco or something to cover that up. Try and leave some of this, but who knows, once you get into a project, or I do, it can go any which way. So, what else do we got now? On the other side of this, this thing pops off really easy, so that'll have to be glued in, caulked in. On the other side of this has some great details, and I love it. But it's not going to work here anymore unless, which I just thought of, I make a balcony that this would be coming off. That might work. That certainly might work. So I'll think about that, just a little balcony. If not, I think some of this stuff wouldn't make sense on a second floor, so I would have to texture that all with caulking. This side will be against the wall and won't matter. And yeah, we'll see how that goes, because those are some really cute little details. Now, you know, in this spot, there's my door, and it opens, and it hits this little thing right here. So I was very limited in my space, and that's why this was custom made. It'll have a little bit of room here for something like that, or the scooter, or something. And then I got to decide what to do with the bottom. What I'd like to see is, of course, my area over on the left of the beach. I'm not getting my spiral staircase. It's not happening with the plan I got going for there. So somewhere in here, I'd like to see either my spiral staircase and or I'd like to get an outhouse down under here. I think that would be really fun. I also have this, which is a stick-on tile. Instead of being a 12 by 12 square, it is long and narrow. This was left over a piece I had bought extra and didn't use in the game room. So now I'm going to try and maybe incorporate that on there, since that's no cost. What else? Oh, let's do a shout out for first on one of the last, which was the In Search of Dracula and Claudia in Walmart. Thank you, Inara. You're pretty quick. You've gotten tons of these first. I'm not even sure how many you've had so far. So let's see, I think that's about it for now for the ideas. I think what we'll do is have Alex help me put this together and make my unit higher, and then we'll go from there to decide what to do next and how to tackle this nice little yet fun and interesting project. See you on the next segment after the repeat of the wood stuff. I love being resourceful. I have went through all of our scrap wood, so I don't have to buy another piece of plywood for using for three projects. Piece of plywood, decent, one side good, one side bad, is about $25. So this is awesome that I thought ahead on my last projects and tried to be very minimal so I could have the best leftover for whatever was to come. Doesn't always work out, but in this case it did. I will add this into all three videos, all three projects, but this is me stopping for you because this is how I work. And I do it for myself because I'm in a measuring mood, and I do it for Alex. His time is very limited, so I like to have everything ready for him to go to just use the power tools. I can use them, but I don't like to. It's just not my favorite thing in the whole wide world to do. So here we have the one big project that when I announced this first is kind of a secret, but it's a base so something doesn't flop over. This is the cabin leftovers. This was actually the hole cut out from Nightmare's stable, if you remember that. So I got nice with that. And then, so that's for the thing. And then I'm going to make it on the top for the live cabin. And then I'm going to put it up on stilts and use that as the base for some exterior landscaping of some sort and add another extra bit of space. And here's the power pop, whatever I figure out what's going to be called, ready to go, all scraps. Here's some scrap wood I got ready for a little shelf for my collector Draculaura. So he's already, you can see by our markings, I get him, R meaning he understands my language. I get them all ready, all the same, put X's on what you want cut off because there's a width of the saw that's about like an eighth of an inch, and he goes left or right of it and knows what to do. So I got all my measurements, bottom, top, front. I've taken the time to look and make sure my knots are hidden and everything's beautiful. So when that goes on the wall, it'll be something like that for a little shelf that'll perfectly fit just her. And of course I'll make that pretty. marks do all the same thing. X is what I want cut off, and lines and whatnot for that. That's me, three at a time. And all of these, $0 at this point because it's all leftover scraps. Love it. Super duper. Here it is thus far after Alex did the putting together of the pieces. He did an awesome job. It looks fantastic. It fits in there really good. The pattern thing worked out well. We had to put one brace back there. We'll still assess. It's very strong. I think it'll be all right. But if we open this up, we have, oops, there we go. That fits on there really good. From this angle, it doesn't look too bad with that stuff on there. Maybe I'll try to make it work. I tested the door and it does open, but this particular plastic piece is in the way, so I'll have to make some adjustments for that, put it somewhere else, or cut it, that bottom piece off, just hold stands. But anyway, here's where we are. So we'll end this on part one. I'm foreseeing at least three parts. Not sure if that will be including or in addition adding the outhouse, which I really want to happen here, but I'm not sure. I've got about a day of sanding and priming, and then want to at least spend a day and do some sketches and try and be a little bit more 100% on which way I want to do things and think about how I'm going to attach this to that. And then I will begin part two. Keep an eye out for it. Hope you like this new video journal series of our cabin by the woods, or the forest as we usually call it. Have a great, great evening or day, depending on what time it is for you around the world. Super buddies forever. Thank you.